Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to the reef. Today, it's coral feeding day. I also think we're going to trim back some area that died on the bird's nest. And is growing algae on it. Oops. Okay. So some of the smaller particles are just going to kind of trigger that feeding response that we want. Get you really close here on the zoanthids if I can. Blueberry fields fell, so that's gonna have to go get that. The better ones, I do have to go get him because he fell. Might just glue him in while we're at it. You can see the egg hands are super engorged and ready to eat. But they get the large pellets. Shouldn't say large. They get the LPS grow. Not a ton. It just goes into the little container of water so I can suck them up. And I just want them all to sink. Sink, sink, sink. So we'll start with them. Get a couple pellets in here. I'm just gonna deposit one or two on them. Can see, which I think you can. Zoom out a little bit more here. So there they go. They've got it. Now they open their mouth. Which is just that gaping hole in the middle. And they move the food into it. Now, these are pretty fast response eaters. Other ones are kind of slow with how long they take to eat. And move the food to their mouth. These octospawn will be next. They won't get a huge number, they'll just get a couple. And then whatever the coral doesn't get, the fish will swoop in and take as well. Here. Do the torch. That was a lot, but it'll be okay. So they'll catch. He'll catch all of that, bring it to his mouth, consume it. Our new hammers probably thoroughly enjoy a meal. And again, all this leftover that you see just kind of floating off, that they're not directly sticking to them, it all just gets consumed. You can see actually right here. The crabs go around and clean it all up. There is a literal army of them. This is my favorite one to see. So we're going to zoom in super close here. Get it nice and focused. Maybe, actually. Go up higher so you can look down at it. Better view. Yeah, that's better. He did. He caught someone at leading edge there. And down here. So we're at 8 minutes and like 50 seconds. Let's see how long it takes for him to consume that. Did not turn off the flow, so I mean ideally the flow would be off right now for their feeding time, so it doesn't blow away from them. 10 minutes and 30 seconds and they're at the tip of his mouth. We're at 11 minutes, so it's been 2 minutes for him to take in this food. It's now inside, and he's closed his mouth out in and around it. That's about 3 minutes worth of time, 2.5, 3 minutes. That's really all I did today. I made a ton of water. Actually, let's... made a proverbial ton of water. As I moved, it's day 6 of the treatment. Well, it's been 6 days. So the fish have been moved to their next stage of their quarantine process. Oh. There's the sand sifting starfish. So they got moved to the next stage, so they're in the next tank, which uses like 20 gallons of water, so I have to make more salt water, which means I have to make more fresh water, and all of that. So it's a very drawn out day of pumping water from one side to another and back and forth. But it's all for their health. So I'm just picking up the blueberry fields. Then I'm going to pick this Ganapora up and put him back in his home as well. And then last but not least, we're just going to get the camera up. So right now you're just staring at the A-cans, which as much as I do love just looking at them, isn't what we're looking at. So this is just trying to get the dead stuff off so the algae can't take hold. And we can hopefully get new tissue growth here. So that's everything for today. I hope you enjoyed the little feeding session. I also topped off their top off water and their I topped off the top off water, and I'm gonna empty the skimmate locker here in a minute. But that's all I have for today. Don't forget to leave a like, and we'll see you tomorrow.